高等法院近日的一项裁决，让寻求庇护者中的140余名曾被无限期拘留的人士获得释放，这包括曾涉嫌多项犯罪行为的人员。其中一名拒绝佩戴电子监控设备的人士获释后甚至一度失踪。为了给社会治安提供多一重保障，29号，工党政府宣布将着手建立一套严厉的预防性拘留制度。
The job of the Parliament now is to work with our government to create the toughest possible preventative detention regime.
目前，预防性拘留只针对恐怖分子和恐怖活动嫌疑人。未来将有哪些罪行被纳入制度执行范围，仍是一个谜题。
The High Court has left space for the Parliament to legislate to get the most dangerous offenders off the streets, and that is the government's goal here. The High Court decision actually specifically refers to child sexual abuse as one of the grounds on which preventative detention might also be lawful. These are the decisions that the government will make over the coming days.
而反对党斥责，工党政府的动作太晚了，让事态的局势越来越难以控制。
What unfortunately has happened is that the government could have been working on this weeks ago, but have just left it. The government seems to be inviting these detainees to be case managed and come forward. I'm not sure that they're going to do that. That meanwhile, Australians are looking at a summer period with a government that is just dissolving in disarray.
移民、公民和多元文化事务部长呼吁反对党不要再一味喊话，坐下来协力探讨制度细则，才真正有益于社会。
We are working to make it an offence for recently released detainees to go within 200 metres of a school, daycare centre or childcare centre. And we expect the opposition to work with us on this because it's not their tough talk that makes a difference. It is strong laws in place.
反对党希望相关法案可以在本周堪培拉休会之前获得议会通过。
No briefings have been offered. No draft legislation has been shared. We are prepared to cooperate, of course, if the government introduces what we ask them to introduce. Of the 141 people have been released, the Immigration Minister has required 138 of them to be wearing electronic monitoring. So that gives you a picture of how many of those do pose a risk to the community.